is Francis Boucher from France. The boxers represent Lithuania and the Republic of Korea, so please give them a warm welcome as they make their way to the ring.
So approaching the ring ahead of this semi-final, representing the Korean Republic, is Han Soon-Chul, part of a two-man boxing team for Korea. 5 feet 10 inches tall, and this is going to be a contest that is a study of contrast in terms of styles and physiques, as awaiting in the red corner for Lithuania is this man, Evaldas Petrauskas, a compact 5 feet 4.5 inches. He just comes with plenty of skill and lots of aggression to wage war, particularly on the body of his opponents, with hurtful hooks and uppercuts. 5'10" is going to be plenty of body to aim at.
Introducing in the red corner, representing Lithuania, Evaldas Petrauskas. And in the blue corner, representing the People's Republic of Korea, Soon-Chul Han. Seconds out, round one.
So the opening bell sounds to begin the first of a scheduled three-minute round in this men's 60-kilogram lightweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, representing Lithuania, Evaldas Petrauskas, 20 years of age, and his opponent, representing the Korean Republic, 27 years of age, 5 feet 10 inches tall, and that is Han Soon-Chul. Good right hand from Han, but Petrauskas, he's demonstrated that he knows one way how to box. There is plenty of skill behind it, but it's a real crowd-pleasing style as he attempts to crowd his opponent and work away with short arcing punches at close quarters.
Yeah, Petrauskas has entertained us throughout this tournament, and he's one of the rare boxers here that is an out-and-out, what we call an in-fighter. So what Petrauskas targets is mid and mainly short-range work. And his best punches are those hooks and uppercuts. Comes very square into his opponent. He is open, but his sheer sustained pressure gets him through. So there's no prizes for guessing what type of tactics both these boxers need to be applying. It's one fighter boxing long range and one boxer on the inside doing the infighting.
It's the fourth contest for both of these men here at this semi-final stage in the Olympic boxing tournament. Good right hand from Petrauskas over the top, as Han found himself pinned in his own corner momentarily. But in his opening bout, Petrauskas outpointed Hungary's Miklos Varga by a score of 20 points to 12. Then he eliminated the number 6 seed, Keles from Turkey, 16 points to 12 in that contest. And then defeated the world's number 1 ranked lightweight, the number 3 seed in the tournament, Domenico Valentino of Italy, by a score of 16 points to 14 to book his place here in the semi-final and guarantee Lithuania's first ever boxing medal as an independent nation.
Well, Han's left jab and right uppercut are absolutely crucial for him to hear tonight. What he can't afford to do is be slow with that jab, because Petrauskas has already landed one right hand over the top, and that's what he'll be targeting as he walks forward. And as soon as Mr. Han's back hits those ropes, he's got to move.
Han going back in straight lines, you see, as he goes from the blue corner to the red corner. He almost went diagonally straight across the ring. working away with the left hand, the free hand was Petrauskas. Good right hand attempted to the body from Hannin. He's trying that right uppercut that you suggested, Richie Woodall.
Yeah, he should also then double it up and throw the right uppercut and finish on the left hook. But this will be a real test of Han's character, mentally as well as physically. Will he panic if he can't keep his man at bay? Got to establish that jab a lot better. But all eyes are on the man in red, who just comes forward looking to land that big shot.
Good right hand to the solar plexus in the form of an uppercut from Han. And as the bell sounds, perhaps that was enough to just tilt the scoring in his favour. Because at the end of one round of boxing, it is 5-4 in favour of Han.
Yeah, I think that's good scoring, good judging. I think Han did land the better shot, especially to the body. The right uppercut, that was borderline. There's that right hand over the top, so that's the punch. Petrauskas has got a target, but we need more head movement from him to land that punch. But that was a good shot there from him. Movement's the key. That was borderline again from Han, just on the blind side of the referee. But this man's tactics, crucial, fast feet, loads of head movement we need, and then work the body, but on the odd occasion, rip the shot over the top.
As we move into the second round of this men's 60-kilogram lightweight semi-final, the boxer wearing blue, representing Korea, Han, the Korean Republic, Han Soon-Chul, is leading by 5-4 at the end of the first round against his opponent, the compact figure, who lands a beautiful left hook as he continues his relentless forward march, Lithuania's Evaldas Petrauskas. We talked about the test of character and the test of fitness that Han may face in facing Petrauskas. He's demonstrated plenty of character to this point in the contest, because this point in the tournament, because most of his contests have been really competitive affairs. In his three bouts today, he prevailed by a score of 11-6 over Egypt's Mohamed Eliwa. And then in the second round, he accounted for the tournament number 2 seed, Safayans of Belarus, 13-13. On countback, he prevailed in that contest, as Petrauskas brings a roar from the crowd as he continues to wade his way forward and unload with big shots at close quarters. And then in the quarterfinal, it was a 16-13 victory over Uzbekistan's Fazlidin Gaibnazarov, which booked Han his place here at the semi-final stage.
Well, a boxer like Petrauskas faces three real problems as an in-fighter, as we say. How to gain that inside position without getting caught, what punches to throw on the inside that are most effective, and then the retreat. How do you get back to the safety, thinking distance, and plan the next attack? He just stays on the inside a little bit too long for my liking, and that just invites a shot like that on the inside from Han. So he's got to just plan his attacks a little bit better, Petrauskas, and he must move his head more on the inside.
Petrauskas continuing to relentlessly march forward once again. Han using the perimeter of the ring. Good check right hand as Petrauskas waded his way forward. But again, Petrauskas impossible to discourage, impossible to deter. But Han just having a little bit of success picking the man off as he makes his way forward.
Yeah, Petrauskas' feet are too slow and the single shot is not working now. He's got to start doubling up and trebling and working the body with combinations, rather than looking for that single overhand right.
Han up on his toes, continuing to dance with a balletic grace, and then takes a hard right hook, left hand combination. He's having good success with that whipping right bolo shot to the body, his hand. And inside these final 30 seconds, he finds his feet just coming a little bit square as his back touches the ropes, dances away from that place of confinement, and again attempts that whipping right bolo shot to the body of Petrauskas. Spearing with straight shots to penetrate the guard, his hand. Petrauskas continues to walk his man down and try to land on the inside. But the man from the Korean Republic has doubled his advantage It was 1 point at the end of the first round. It now stands at 2-11 points to 9 in favour of Han.
Well, the crowd don't like it. There's boos, and that's because they see the man coming, just coming forward in red. But he's not really landing with the better punches. Han, on the other hand, gets caught there as Petrauskas comes forward. But there's too many single shots. Here we are from another angle there. That was a great attack from Petrauskas, but it's all single shots. Han's just nicking the punches downstairs. Petrauskas has got to punch now in threes and fours and target the man's body and switch that attack.
Into the third and final round we go in this men's 60 kilogram lightweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red from Lithuania, Evaldas Petrauskas, and his opponent from the Korean Republic, Han Soon-Chul, part of a two-man boxing team, and it is Han Soon-Chul who leads by 2 points. And so you know what response that is going to bring here in this third and final round. Petrauskas is trying to quicken his feet. He's stepping on the gas and just marching forwards in an effort to land his own hurtful shots that he's bombing away with both the left and right hand. But just look at the beautiful boxing being exhibited by Han, moving effectively, picking his punches efficiently, and Petrauskas finding himself out of punching range to begin this third and final round. There's evidence of it once more, falling well short with a lead left hook attempt.
Now the problem he's got, the way he's coming forward, is a little bit reckless and just ties himself up on the inside, just launching and lunging in.
Fell face first into the ropes on that occasion.
Now he should work the body and switch to the head, Petrauskas.
Again, Han continuing to target the body effectively. Petrauskas, well, he only boxes in one direction, but the movement of Han has been really effective tonight, and he is struggling to close the distance.
I think the effects as well of two hard contests for Petrauskas has taken its toll here, the two or three that he's had. Three hard contests, should I say. And I just think he's showing signs now that he's slowing down a little bit. He can't find the quality punches.
He's eliminated two seeds en route to this semi-final, the number six seed and the number three seed, who is also the world-ranked number one boxer, the world champion from 2009, Domenico Valentino. So he's acquitted himself excellently here at the Olympic Games. He's just 20 years of age, part of a two-man Lithuanian boxing team. And again, falls short with a looping, arcing overhand right. But he was one of the 44 boxers who was on AIBA's Road to London camp. So he trained intensively there, benefited from expertise and medical backup and nutritional support over in Cardiff, and he really has put that to terrific effect here at the Olympic Games, and he's one of the crowd favorites, as Han he's worn for straying low with that right-handed bolo shot to the body that has been so effective throughout the course of this contest.
Keeps making mistakes though here, Petrauskas, the way he's walking forward, just looking for that shot. He needs that speed jab. That was a little bit better with that hook, and again, too little too late though for my liking.
He's getting through effectively now. This is what the crowd want to see. Petrauskas is having success with some thunderous shots from both left and right hand. But Han has really used his legs to terrific effect and picked his punches wonderfully during the course of that semi-final bout. He led going into that third and final round. And it will be interesting to see whether Petrauskas has done enough to overturn the deficit. It's unlikely. The man in blue appeared to have done enough to book his place in the final, but we will go to the scorecards.
Is that right up? We've got the inside for Petrauskas. Well, I know who wants to win, who the crowd want to win rather, but too often in the first 2.5 minutes of this round we had an attack like that and a reply from Han. At the end, Petrauskas did get through. This is the last 30 seconds or so with the odd single shot. His corner think he may have done enough. I'm not so sure.
Won Lithuania's first ever Olympic boxing medal, regardless of the outcome. And as Pozniakas won light heavyweight gold in 1968 for the Soviet Union. He's a native of what's now Lithuania. What will the outcome be in this semi-final?
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 18 points to 13 in the blue corner, representing the Republic of Korea, Sunshine Hain.
Well, the crowd are voicing their displeasure, but that is perhaps one of their favourite boxers has been eliminated. Evaldas Petrauskas fought valiantly, as he always does, but he has been eliminated, and he deserves this round of applause that he's getting, because he has put on a spectacular spectacle during the course of his Olympic tournament. But he was outboxed tonight by the man from the Korean Republic, Han Soon-chol, receiving warm congratulations from his corner, and he deserves his place in the Olympic final, because he produced a really good boxing performance. His tactics were spot on, his use of the feet was terrific, and he is deservedly through to the gold medal bout.